Cinema Caffeine presents
The Robot Monster!
These two twerps wander to the mouth of a cave, tormenting these archaeologists. Reunited with family, they go take a nap. Johnny returns, falling down when a comet appears. Some randomly occurring rubber dinos have a bit of argy-bargy, knocking each other in the head and doing judo throws off a cliff. He awakes to see alien communication equipment that blows menacing soap bubbles. A portly ape with a metal helmet waddles out and jibber-jabbers with his leader. The shaggy droids discuss how their death ray has killed everyone on the Earth, except for seven survivors. Roman, the robot monster, goes on a seek-and-destroy mission.
None shall escape me.
The defiant survivors...
No!
...had somehow immunized themselves from the calcinator death rays. Roman hits them up on FaceTime, offering a quick death upon surrender.
Show yourselves and I promise you a painless death.
No!
His boss is constantly bellyaching.
Fail, and I will destroy you.
Roy, an unexpected survivor, reunites with the others. He teams up with Alice to get an encrypted message to surviving astronauts, but fails. Donkey Kong gives them a backwards counting lesson.
10, 9...
Before he destroys the rocket. Kapow! The long-winded yakking really does put the die in dialogue. Roman gets the hots for Alice.
I will talk with the girl. It is only the one called Alice that I want to see.
No!
Alice demands to meet Roman for a dream date.
Where shall we meet? I will be there.
No!
But they hug-tie her, and Johnny darts off to taunt the cybernetic Care Bear.
You look like a pooped-out pinwheel.
Now I will kill you.
Impervious to the death ray, the punk boasts about how they've been immunized. Gorilla Face storms off.
There must be an end to your race.
Roy and Alice leave to confront Fuzzy Wuzzy, but they end up hiding, pantomiming, and snogging. Stood up by Alice, Fuzzy mopes back to his crib. Well, they get marriaged up. Roman gets orders to destroy the survivors with physical force. Carla, picking flowers for the newlyweds, gets murked by Roman.
I shall find a way to rid this Earth planet of humans.
Honeymoon's over when Grape Ape offs hubby and nabs Alice. He's getting fresh back at the cave.
Suppose I were human. Would you treat me like a man?
But then he bonks her on the head. The others finally request a quick death.
Come and get us.
But Roman makes some smooth moves on Alice instead. His perturbed supervisor phones him and warns him to stick with the mission, or else. Roman gets bitched at for being feelsy and fickle.
To be like the human, to laugh, feel, want. Why are these things not in the plan? Destroy the girl. I cannot, yet I must. How do you calculate that? At what point on the graph you must and cannot meet? Yet I must what I cannot.
Johnny makes a diversion.
Get out of here, Roman!
While Mom and Pops rescue Alice and smash the communication unit. Roman strangles him. But at this point, the CEO of Roman Incorporated has had enough of his indecision. Roman himself is destroyed with his own death ray. He dead. Harambe over here unleashes the Thunder Lizards and an earthquake to kill off the survivors. Turns out this whole nightmare was literally just a concussion-induced nightmare.
Well, that's quite a bump there, boy. What happened?
Boy, was that a dream or was it?
We suspected take a sequence of head injuries to dream this mess up. At least Roy scores a heavily chaperoned 50 Styles dinner date with Alice.
Won't you and your assistant join us for dinner? Do.
Done.
No!
They depart in peace, though a phantom Roman approaches three times, causing uncertainty and sheer terror at the prospect of being eradicated by a cross between a Teletubby and a maniacal furry convention reject. Well, that's about it for now, folks. Unless your tolerance for pain is true to roof, I might skip this one. I plan to watch more of these stupid movies, so you don't have to. Thanks again, and we'll see you later.
No!